them letting you get close to them, in this situation, do not attempt to touch them or to try to pull on their distinctive white-tipped tail. The Philippines has the greatest variety of nudibranchs in the world. On almost any dive in this country, the observant diver will be able to see a few different examples. These naked snails have two little horns called rhinophores. The wavy cluster at the back are the gills. Their bright flashy colors serve as a warning to all predators that these seemingly defenseless creatures are highly poisonous to eat. Due to their distinctive coloration and unique special patterns, and the fact that they move slowly, nudibranchs are a highly sought after photo subject. When swimming away after taking your photo though, please take care that you don't kick up the sand because it might clog their gills. Have you ever wondered why white sand is so clean and pure? Sea cucumbers are like biological vacuum cleaners. Most species live on the bottom where they move about by stretching and contracting their bodies. They feed by taking in whatever is on the sea bottom and digesting all the organic particles. Et voila, out the back comes clean white sand. The giant sea cucumber can grow up to 3 meters long. Feather stars are very decorative and colorful. Although seemingly fragile, they've been around for millions of years. They usually have between 10 to 20 long and delicate feeding arms. These are like Velcro and are used to filter out plankton. While perched onto a sea fan or coral, a feather star will stretch out its arms into the current to feed. When not feeding, it will curl into a tight ball. If the current provides enough plankton, they will remain in the same spot for weeks. For many, the sea star is a symbol of the sea and its wonders. Most sea stars have 5 arms, but some species can have up to 20. The underside of the arms have many tiny legs which end in suckers. These voracious predators even have enough strength to force clams open. Although slow walkers, they can also hunt down relatively large animals such as the octopus. Hermit crabs occupy any empty shell that they find suitable to their size. That is why you should not collect empty shells while diving. They never leave their shell unless moving into a larger one in order to always protect their vulnerable bodies from attackers. When in danger, hermits can retract completely into their shell, sealing off the entrance with their largest pincer. Their eyes are located on rods, which they can extend in order to scan the surroundings before they come out again. Shrimps are mostly tiny invertebrates recognizable by their hook-shaped bodies, multiple small legs, and long feelers. They are mostly night-active creatures that have specialized niches in the reef ecosystem. You can sometimes see them cleaning the mouths and gills of large predators like moray eels. Often they are found in a symbiosis, keeping anemones free of parasites. Due to the fact that there are over 8,000 species of shrimps, if you look very carefully in the most unlikely places of a reef, you will certainly encounter a shrimp. Of course, humans look for the ones that taste good and are at least bite-sized. Mike Tyson, watch out! Mantis shrimp pack the most powerful punch in the animal kingdom. Large individuals in captivity have even been known to punch a hole through thick aquarium glass. They can swim using their tails, but usually just run along the bottom on 3 pairs of legs. Some species hunt by using their specialized front legs as clubs to crack open the shells of crabs and other invertebrates. Others have evolved a spear-like appendage in order to catch fish. An octopus has 8 arms, which are also used for tasting, smelling, and feeling its surroundings. Each of these incredibly strong arms has up to 240 suckers. It can camouflage itself perfectly by changing the color and texture of its skin at an incredible speed. This ability can also be used to express emotions such as fear or lust. It is a means of communication with each other during courtship. An octopus usually walks along the bottom using its arms. In an emergency, it can speed away using water jet propulsion and ejecting a screen of black ink as a distraction. This invertebrate has no bones, which is why it can squeeze through cracks that are tiny compared to its body size. An octopus only lives to a maximum of 3 years. Very closely related to the octopus is the cuttlefish. It is also amazingly intelligent and possesses excellent eyesight through its beautiful golden eyes. One major difference is that the cuttlefish does not walk along the sea bottom. Instead, it has a streamlined shape for swimming. Another difference is that the cuttlefish has 10 arms instead of 8. Being very curious creatures, cuttlefish sometimes interact with divers, if they feel like it, by gesturing with their arms and changing colors. When this happens, it's as if it's trying to tell us something we should know. If they don't feel like fooling around with divers, they'll camouflage themselves so well that they won't be found. Jacks are some of the most voracious hunters in the ocean. They are also known as trevellies or mackerels. They are frequently to be seen in schools, but occasionally one can meet solitary large animals. These can be extremely interested in everything happening around them. Sometimes they follow divers around during the whole dive. This can give us the impression that they have nothing better to do and that there is nothing good on fish TV. These pelagic hunters are the marathon swimmers among fish. Tunas never stop swimming and they never sleep. Unlike most fish, they can raise their body temperature in order to increase their performance. Tunas are commonly encountered in groups of between 3 to 20 individuals. The species of dogtooth tuna is sometimes confused with white-tipped reef sharks due to the white spot on its fin and its similar size. When barracudas are young, they can be found in schools of hundreds of individuals. As they get older, the schools get smaller. Schools of young barracuda are harmless. Even in the strongest currents, these sleek torpedo-shaped hunters hang out above the reef without obvious effort. Barracudas are curious and may circle divers to take a closer look. Being surrounded by so many barracudas that all you see are silvery fish bodies makes you feel as if you were a part of them. This is truly an unforgettable experience. Sea turtles are so well adapted to the water that unlike their cousins on land, they are not slow and clumsy. Instead, their legs have developed into fins which propel them rapidly and gracefully through the aquatic environment. The majority of their time is spent underwater, resting in small caves or searching among corals for jellyfish, plants, and invertebrates to eat. However, being reptiles, they must periodically surface to breathe. Do not imitate ignorant divers who hitch rides on turtles. Holding onto a turtle can cause it to panic. Be aware that a panicked turtle might swim so deep that it can drown. If you glimpse a fast movement out of the corner of your eye while swimming along a sandy slope, chances are it is a blue-spotted stingray.